Hey guys, this is John with Greenfish Nation. I want to welcome you to our channel today. Today will be our first installment of How to Be a Better Fisherman. I was presented a question by a viewer just recently. If I could only choose three rod and reels to have in my arsenal to cover all types of bass fishing, what would those three be? So you guys stay tuned for the answer. Alright guys, the question was presented. You can only have three rod and reels. What are those three rod and reels going to be? Here I've chosen the three rod and reels out of my rod locker that I would personally have if that's all I was able to fish with. First things first, before we get started on this, I want to tell you guys I am a firm believer in these little rod socks. They're like $5-6 a piece. They'll save you a lot of headache in your rod locker, especially if you're fishing out of a boat. They'll keep you from getting tangled up, your lines all wadded up together and all that. They're just a good practice, guys. If you're not using those, you probably should be. My first choice is going to be a 7'1" heavy action with a fast tip loose speed stick, and I've got this paired with a loose reel, and this is a 7'5-1. I use this rod for pretty much everything that you can imagine. I throw jigs with it, I throw chatterbaits, I throw topwaters like frogs and heavy cover situations, punch rigs. I really like this rod for that. It's pretty good general purpose rod for all of those things, but I believe you can fish anything with this. Given the right techniques, okay? The second choice, I have here an Abu Garcia, and this is a 7-foot rod, and it's a medium heavy action rod. I have it paired with a 6'4-1 Abu Garcia Black Max. I use this primarily for throwing spinner baits, crank baits, just anything that I want to give that fish an extra fraction of a second to get a good grip on that bait before I set the hook. I want to have this type of rod. Like I said, this is a medium heavy action. It's got a fairly soft tip, and that gives you that extra little bit that you need. I have this paired, like I said, this reel paired with this rod because it's a little bit slower gear ratio. I use monofilament on all of those things. That gives me that little bit of stretch I need, so that's a little bit more of an advantage to get that good hookup. Okay, and the third rod that I have is an underspin rod. This is a loose rod also. This rod is 6'9". It's medium action, and it also has that soft tip on it. I use this for a multitude of things. I was just out fishing with a good buddy of mine yesterday, and I was throwing a Ned rig on it. That's what I've got tied on it right now. This is paired with a loose underspin, and this one here is a 5'2-1 gear ratio. I love this little rod. You can just fish a multitude of things with it. It'll throw the lightest little old crankbaits, balsa wood crankbaits. Sometimes I throw a jerkbait with it. I throw a Senko on it a lot. Anything weightless, lightweight. Do a lot of finesse fishing with it. That's my choice for drop shotting. Also, like I said, Ned rigs and all that. But guys, these would be my three choices if I could only have three rods in the boat. These are the rods that I would want to arm myself with. If I was going to be a co-angler with someone in a tournament and I didn't want to clutter up the boat with a bunch of junk, I'd pack me a small tackle box with the lures that I thought were going to work that day on that lake that I could use these rods with, guys. I hope this has helped you guys out. I hope this helps you to become a better angler. We have videos on the use of bait casters and the underspins on how to completely set those up. If you guys are new to those, give them a try. Check out those videos. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, I'd love it if you would do that. Turn on that notifications bell. And most of all, become a better fisherman and keep those lines tight. I'm John with Greenfish Nation. Thanks for joining us today.